Bam! Mr. Tarrou, in this calculus lesson, we're going to be looking at a four-part question that involves part A, writing a third-degree Talyor polynomial, part B, working with and writing the first non-three-zero terms of Maclaurin series. We're going to be doing a product of a couple of Maclaurin series, basically. We're going to be looking at part C, which is going to be evaluating or estimating some function at a value, that function which is going to be based off and using the Talyor polynomial that we come up with in part A. And then part D, we're going to be finding the upper bound of the error, or the alternating, using the alternating series error theorem, basically. So that's going to be our four parts. In the description, you'll find timestamps to jump ahead to each of these four parts. You'll find timestamps, or not timestamps, but links to the APCentral College Board website. If you want to find some old AP tests that you can use to study for and find the tests, find the marking schemes, find the master graders comments, you can see where students earned and did not earn their points. You can find playlists for all of my calculus lessons. And if you want to find some problems to help you look at some AP style problems to review, you can find that as well. So our question here says, a function f has derivatives of all orders for all real numbers of x. A portion of the graph of f, that's this graph right here, that is concave up, is shown along with the line tangent to the graph of f at x is equal to 0. So we're going to get this set up out of our way. We're going to be pulling some information off of this graph and this table as we go through the four parts. Certainly the first part of this question, as we get my fancy picture out of there, we're going to write the third degree Talyor polynomial for f about x is equal to 0. Remember, this Talyor polynomial is something that we're coming up with that is going to be able to approximate values of function f centered about the point of x is equal to 0. Okay, so our third degree Talyor polynomial centered about 0 is going to be equal to f of 0 plus the first derivative of f at 0 over 1 factorial times x minus c, x minus the center at which you're going to construct this Talyor polynomial, which is 0, so I'm just writing that for notes purposes, plus f double prime of 0 over 2 factorial times x minus 0 to the second, plus the third derivative of f at 0 over 3 factorial times x minus 0 to the third power. So that's sort of the framework we're going to be using. You might very well be able to just simply write the answer, but I'm going to, in case anyone's struggling, help you figure this out. So p sub 3 of x is equal to, okay, f of 0. Remember, this is f, and that function's value at 0 is equal to 4. So f of 0 is 4. Now, the value of the derivative of f of 0, the slope of f at the instantaneous rate of change at 0 is, well, we have the tangent line given to us in the graph. Well, yeah, of course, we can just look at a graph and say, oh, the slope of a line is rise over run, so we're going to go down 3 and over 1. So the slope there is equal to negative 3 over 1 factorial, which is 1, times x to the first. Now we have plus f double prime of 0. Yeah, second derivative of f at 0. So the second derivative of f at 0 is equal to 1. So we're looking at 1 over 2 factorial is 2, times x squared, and then plus the third derivative of f at 0 is equal to negative 12 over 7 times 1 over 3 factorial, which is 1 over 6, x cubed. So the answer to part A here, our third degree Talyor polynomial is going to be 4 minus 3x plus x squared over 2. Of course, the 6 and the 12 will cancel, giving us negative 2. So we have minus 2 sevenths x cubed. I'm just making sure I didn't write something silly. we are good. Part B coming up right now. So, part B, it says for the first part of part B, we're going to write the first three non-zero terms of the Maclaurin series for e to the x. And of course, the difference between a Maclaurin series and a Taylor series is that the center is at zero. And we have that list of common Maclaurin series that we do generally need to have memorized for the AP test. I'm not sure what your teachers and college professors may possibly be doing, but like we're looking for the sort of elementary series such as 1 over x, 1 over 1 plus x, the natural log of x, e to the x, sine of x, cosine of x. Of course, if you know the sine of x, you can find the Maclaurin series for the cosine of x by simply taking the derivative. And then we have arc tan, arc sine, and 1 plus x to the k power, at least as is defined as the common Maclaurin series in the book that I teach from, Larson Calculus. Well, for e to the x, we're looking for 1 plus x to the first over 1 factorial plus x squared over 2 factorial plus x cubed over 3 factorial, and that continues on until you get to that general term of x to the n power over n factorial. And then because it's a series, it just goes on forever, plus dot, dot, dot. But the question simply asked for us to write the first three non-zero terms, not write out the entire common Maclaurin series. So, there's our answer to the first part here. Now we're going to write the second degree Taylor polynomial for e to the x times f of x. We're going to look at that Taylor polynomial that we came up with just in part A and combine that with the first three non-zero terms of a Maclaurin series. Taylor polynomial, that center of that Taylor polynomial was zero, so we're all great. All we have to do is take that basically what we have here, the first three non-zero terms of our Maclaurin series for e to the x, 1 plus x plus 1 half x squared, and multiply that with the Taylor polynomial that we just found, which was... Now normally, I want to write my Taylor polynomials, or just my polynomials in general, with the powers going from high to low, but here we want just a second degree Taylor polynomial. So I really want to work with those terms that are in these polynomials with the degrees or powers of zero and those small powers. So I'm going to leave it the way it was written originally, which is 4 minus 3x plus 1 half x squared minus 2 sevenths x cubed, and start just distributing this together. But not all of it. We only want a second degree Taylor polynomial. So we're going to do 1 times 4, which is 4. We have 1 times negative 3x, so negative 3x, and then plus a 1 half x squared. And I'm going to go ahead and stop with that multiplication, that distribution with our first term, because I've just gotten to a power of 2. No reason to go to the negative 2 sevenths x cubed. Now we'll move on to x. We have x times 4, which is going to be 4x, and we have x times negative 3x, which is going to be, of course, negative 3x squared, and, okay, if we do the x times the 1 half x squared, we're going to have a something with a third power, third degree, so we're going to go to now our third term and our first factor. We have 1 half x squared times 4, which is going to give us, well, of course, half of 4 is equal to 2. Combine like terms and we're done. When you glance at this, it might feel a little bit tricky, but basically as long as you have that that common Maclaurin series memorized for e to the x, this is really just a distribution problem. So we have negative, we have 2 minus 3 is negative 1. Negative 1 plus a 1 half is negative 1 half x squared. We've got a 4 minus 3x, which is going to give us a plus 1x, and plus 4, and in case unless I just made some kind of silly error, we are good to go. That is the answer to part B. Part C coming up right now. So for part C, we have let h be the function defined by h of x is equal to the definite integral from 0 to x of f of t dt. So basically we have like an accumulation function here, starting from accumulating a rate of change for h of x off of 0. And we're going to use the Talyor polynomial found in part A to approximate for h of 1 half. See, so h is related to, very closely to, the function basically of f of x. We just don't have an x here because that independent variable is being used as an upper limit here on our accumulating function. And a Talyor polynomial is used to approximate, right? This third degree Talyor polynomial that we had in part A, I say that, but I say it's this one like it's up on the board. It's created to be an estimate of f of x. So it makes sense that we should be able to accumulate or integrate with our Talyor polynomial to find, to estimate an area under that curve off of 0. Okay, so we have here that h of 1 half is equal to the definite integral from 0 to 1 half of f of t dt, but it said use the Talyor polynomial that we found in part A. That's why I had to go back and get my notes. So we're looking here at equals to the definite integral from 0 to 1 half of, and we had -2/3, -2/7 x cubed plus 1 half x squared minus 3x plus 4 dx. Okay, so let's go ahead and just double check here, make sure to make a copier. Okay, here we go. So we're going to say that we're going to write an equal sign next to each line of work in case there's some kind of small error and we don't want to get marked off for a linking error. We're looking at raise that power by 1 and divide, so -2/28 times x to the 4th. Raise that power by 1 and divide, so we're looking at 1/6 x cubed minus 3/2 x squared. Plus 4x, that upper limit of 1 half, lower limit of 0. All of these terms have a factor of 0, so when we plug in 0 for x, these are all going to be 0. So we're just going to focus on the 1 half. So we have -2/28 times 1 half to the 4th power plus 1/6, 1 half to the 3rd. Minus 3/2, 1 half squared plus 4 times 1 half minus, and again, all of this is equal to 0 when we plug in our lower limit of 0. So we have 2, 4, 8, 16, and right off, let's see here. Yeah, we have negative, this is going to be 1/14, because that reduces, times 1/14/16 plus 1/6, 1/8 minus 3/2, 1/4 plus 2, plus 0. So we have 14 times 16. 10 times 140 is 10 times 14 is 140. We have 6 times 10, which is 60. We have 6 times 4, which is 24. So we're looking at 224. So -1/224 plus 1/48 minus 3/8 plus 2. And this is what happens when you make up your own numbers. This is going to come out to a nice, easy, rounded off number, not really, of 1103 over 672. So to summarize all that up, h of 1 half is approximately equal to, using the third degree Talyor polynomial from part A, which estimates f of x, of 1103 over 672. Our last part coming up, of course, right now. For part D, our last part, assume the Maclaurin series for H converges to H of X for all real numbers X and the individual terms of the series H of 1/2 alternate sign and decrease in absolute value to zero. Basically just setting up the conditions here that are going to allow us to safely answer the actual question, what is the upper bound of the error for the approximation of H of 1/2? Well, they basically just told us that what we're dealing with is an alternating series, that the individual terms of the series H of 1/2 alternate signs and they're decreasing and decreasing in absolute value until they get to zero. Okay, so the upper bound for an alternating series is less than or equal to the last negated or neglected, term. Well, we found function H of, basically H of X, by integrating our F of T function, or F of function, and the approximation came from the third degree Taylor polynomial. Well, if we worked with and integrated a third degree Taylor polynomial to estimate basically H of X and then approximate H of 1/2, then the first negated term is going to come from, negated or neglected term, is going to come from the fourth degree, or that last term, not the last term of the third degree Taylor polynomial, but that then fourth term. So what we're going to be doing is saying that we're going to be integrating or finding the first neglected term by integrating from 0 to 1/2, 0 to 1/2 of, okay, to find that fourth degree term of the Taylor polynomial, we need to work with the fourth derivative of f about 0, which is going to be that value numerically is 26 over then 4 factorial, so 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 is going to be 24 x to the fourth dx, right? Okay, so our approximation for h of 1/2 was created and found by using the third degree Taylor polynomial. We integrated it, yes, we got up to sort of like a fourth power, but that was after integration, so now we're going to go to the next term, the first neglected term, which we're going to create by integrating the fourth power term of that Taylor polynomial. So we have the definite integral from 1/2, 0 to 1/2 of what, 13 over 12, x to the fourth dx, that is going to give us 13 over 12 times 5, x to the fifth, 1/2 to 0. So we're looking at 13 over 60 times 1/2 to the fifth power, then minus 0. So we're looking at 13 over 60 times 2 to the fifth, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. And that comes out to a nice small number of 13 over 19, 20. So the maximum amount we can be off from our estimation of h of 1/2 is 13 over 1920. I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework.